And now for the thrilling conclusion of who will he pick?
Yes.
Is it the Bug Lady? Is it Godzilla? Or is it Nanomachine Lady? Place your bets now.
Or maybe he'll go for the secret fourth option and romance Ghidora.
Space Elf.
I'm excited.
Oh boy. I can't believe that this series, or that this trilogy has been derailed by who he's gonna pick and not the fact that Ghidorah's a ghost.
I mean, it's the romantic subplot, it's been thrust before us and him, and I look forward to what was supposed to be a dramatic monster anime turn into a weird romantic comedy.
It's gonna be good times. All right, we'll be back in, I don't know, like 90 minutes.
Yep. Okay, what the actual flying fuck? This man knocked up a bug lady. He chose right. He slept with the bug lady. Then he got her pregnant.
No, hang on. He didn't sleep with the bug lady. He slept with the bug lady's sister.
Yes, he slept with the angry bug lady, who was the one who gave her the secretions that saved him from the Mecha Godzilla, and then he's like, oh no, we're gonna repeat the mistakes of the past. Let me grab my brain-dead ex-girlfriend, get into the mech, and kill myself with Godzilla!
Look, he is the only one who knew hatred. Nobody else knew hatred.
That's stupid!
It was unique to him. Nobody else has ever hated before. Especially not the bug people. They don't have a word for that, somehow.
Well, yeah, because the bug people...
Bugs live a life of peace, I guess. Despite having weaponry.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, it was all... The alien elf man was like, haha, I will convince people to join my religion, which is the religion of Ghidora.
Crazy.
Ender of all things. Because that's what Ghidora does.
They use the power of garbage to talk to Ghidora. And Ghidorah comes in and it's like, I'm from another dimension. I'm a weird shiny noodle.
I'm gravity incarnate.
I distort everything.
Even time.
We're already dead, Kenshiro.
You are stuck.
Half of this movie is characters just talking about what we're already seeing.
That's because Ghidorah is bending the plot.
Oh my god.
We
Ghidorah is not a Gordon.
We haven't seen it yet because Ghidorah's gravity field is bending it.
Oh my god. Okay, so... Alright. Let me start with the positives. Because there aren't that many.
It was short.
Number one. And no, it wasn't.
Yeah, it was. We didn't start until like 5.
Yeah.
And it was over at 6:20.
This movie still dragged like a motherfucker.
That's because all the gravity was weighing it down!
Oh my god. Anyway, the positives. No, there are positives.
Godzilla did a tail swipe.
That was lame.
That was more than he did in the last movie.
No, he did a tail thing.
Not in the last movie, he didn't.
In the first one, he did.
In the first one, he did, not the second one.
Oh, that's... But, like, yeah.
Second one, all he did was fire a beam and then walk down a hallway.
Yeah, no, that did happen.
And then he melted.
Yeah. The coolest thing in this movie was the fucking, when Godzilla fires his beam and it bends. And I was like, oh, that's a fucking cool gravitational, refraction, that's so like that feeds that physics nerd inside me, and I was like, oh, there's some really cool ideas, but you have to watch the writing trip and stumble and repeat itself over and over because they have to get to a conclusion that we already knew. what if it's not from this universe?
Yeah, but
no
they,
shit!
They didn't know that.
But we did, and the movie is treating us like we're stupid.
We're watching Godzilla.
You're not wrong. But this Godzilla movie tried to be smart. It was close. It was doing some really cool things. It was playing with ideas of gravity and space-time. And I was like, okay, alright. Now just give me something. Take it home. Take it to the end zone. And instead they fumble it into like, it's from another dimension. and then that's it.
Well, they had to drop it. Like I keep saying, the gravity was so high. You can't hold something.
It's too heavy. Unlike Godzilla, who gets lifted into the air. How can it lift something? Why can't we see it on our sensors? But it's right in front of us. It's biting him. But we're not seeing it. He's heating up. But the heat's going away. What could it mean? Oh my god. Half of this movie was people saying stupid shit and talking in circles.
Yeah, it's a Godzilla movie. Ground air.
That being said, the beam bending was awesome. Also, Haruo chose the right girl. Sort of. I'm fine with him choosing the sister. Don't care. I prefer a girl with attitude anyway. He chose the right one. He got with the bug lady. That's all I cared about. Freaking childhood friend didn't come back as a techno zombie, so I am down.
I can't believe she didn't get stronger.
I mean, she survived essentially death, but her brain was dead, so it didn't fucking matter.
Then she got some nice metal pants and everything. It was great.
Yeah, no, it was awesome.
And then she was forcibly put into a mech that exploded.
Good, that's great. Awesome. Yep. Good times. All right, so the bad. Ghidorah looks like shit.
Yeah, he's got spider eyes. It's great.
He's got spider eyes. He's way too like weird and narrow and asymmetrical, and he's asymmetrical, and at the same time, he's just like a spiky noodle.
Yeah, no, that's all he is. He's just a very long spiky noodle.
Just three long spiky noodles come out and go
with giant underbites.
One of them had, like, underbite, like a third of the jaw was, like, past his top jaw.
I think all
jaw.
Of them were that.
Either way.
I mean, one of them isn't that anymore, because he's got his jaw just snapped off.
Yeah, that was cool, I guess.
I mean, it kind of loses any, like, weight when you just go, yep, it was just the color gold.
Yeah.
And that's it.
And what's even lamer is that all it really was that Ghidorah went back to its own dimension. He didn't actually die.
He got legitimately dusted.
Like Biollante.
Except we didn't see the face of dead daughter flying into space.
Oh, it should have been the face of dead elf alien. That'd have been cool. But no, it's just like...
Oh, and then Godzilla made gravity explode. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, that was dumb. Fired his beam through it and the gravity balls just went boom! Did less damage than Godzilla did when he landed.
Well, yeah, because those were up. The gravity was, like, condensed up there and exploded, but it inverted the explosion.
It literally was just his fat ass hitting the ground. Let's not pretend. Anyway, here's the part that bugs me.
Ah.
Besides the bugs. The bugs don't bug me. I'm into it. Because they're mostly humanoid. That's the main reason. I don't know how the rest of it works, but I mean, hey, whatever. Anyway, I don't want to get... I'll look up what I need to look up later. Anyway, why did Ghidorah become corporeal once the eye thing was broken? The whole point of the eye thing was that Metfi's, or whatever his name is, guide Ghidorah, because Ghidorah was not of this world. Why would breaking that suddenly make it so Godzilla could be like, oh, now I can punch you?
Because it, like, decreased the gravity around Ghidorah.
Shut up!
It inverted the flow of gravity, meaning that Ghidorah could now no longer push away its hacks. Or I don't know.
Oh my god.
It was really dumb. I don't know why he was wearing it as a contact.
I mean, I was fine with it as an idea. It's just that the rules that were set up weren't consistent.
Look, Ghidorah is as Ghidorah does.
Mm-mm, whatever. He didn't even fire gravity beams.
That's because he was the gravity beam!
It's still stupid.
He wrapped himself around a spaceship and just exploded it from the inside. And then they were already dead before they were dead. And they got a communication 40 seconds from the past.
Yeah.
Also, the other aliens, the dwarves, were like, yeah, fuck main character guy. He blew up our city.
Despite the fact that it basically just gave away exactly how we were going to take over your entire civilization. Don't worry about that. We're gonna hold your power hostage.
We're going to turn off the machine and fuck you.
I like how the plan to cool down that whole standoff never took place.
There wasn't any time for it.
Clearly. Ghidorah stole it all. Yeah, so... More bad, other than, like, I talked about, I yelled about how people are talking in circles, and they're not getting anywhere, and the final conclusion is stupid. It's like, yeah, we know Ghidorah is from another dimension. Tell me something I actually do not know.
Ghidorah's made of gravity.
They literally, like...
Well, they told you that first, that he's made of gravity, and you're like, oh...
Yeah, and I thought that was a cool idea, and they played with that for a little bit, and then, because there are some cool bits to this if you know theories about gravity.
And I do not.
Okay, so there's because gravity is one of the four fundamental forces of the universe.
Ah, Jesus, there's three more?
Electromagnetism, the normal nuclear force. The strong and weak nuclear forces, and then gravity. And gravity is actually the weakest by a significant margin, by a huge amount. And it's actually, there's a theory that a significant amount of gravity's power, because it should be the same relative to the other fundamental forces, is actually concentrated in another universe, in a different dimension. So that's really cool, because that's Ghidorah being gravity-based and coming out from another dimension is, like, playing with that idea. Again, you have to be, like, a physics nerd to get that. So, like, they've got these really cool ideas, but then the movie's just like, he's from another dimension. We can't see him, but we can see him.
Well, they're not physics nerds.
But they don't bother to... Oh, my God. Like, they... It's such a, like, quasi-intelligent idea, and then it looks like garbage, and the characters are speaking like morons, and then Godzilla blows up Ghidorah and his three holes.
Okay, so if you guys are at this point now and you're wondering why we haven't really, like, summarized the plot at all, it's because there's not really a plot.
There really isn't!
It's just, hey, the elves are getting people to worship Ghidorah. Oh, Ghidorah. Oh, Ghidorah gone.
Ghidorah ate a bunch of people from the shadows. It was cool. That happened. I forgot to mention that. That was cool. It made squishy noises.
And only one guy noticed.
Yeah, it was crazy. That guy was fucking crazy. He had the crazy eyes. It was great. Yeah, like, there was a point, like, halfway through these morons literally talking about how our instruments can't see it, but we can see it, so it must be real, but our instruments can't see it. I literally said out loud, oh my god, this movie is boring as shit. And then Godzilla blows up all of Ghidorah's holes, and we get, like, this shitty stop-motion, crappy montage thing of the people integrating with the bug people, and then we see that Haruo got, Mina. There's Miana and Mina.
Yeah, yeah.
I believe Mina.
He got Sundari pregnant.
He got Mina pregnant, I'm pretty sure. And I was like, oh my god, they kept at it. Great, awesome. This is exactly what I wanted. Hybrid babies! Anyway, freaky bug babies. And I'm like, wow, this is crazy. And then it starts cutting back to, like, the actual stuff, and it's Scientist Man talking about the mech, and he's like, I used the sample from your dead ex-girlfriend.
I hope you're cool with that.
It's fine,
poking around in there.
And I reactivated it, and we could just rebuild civilization. Then he has a vision from what's-his-face that he's like, you're gonna rebuild it all. And you're going to summon another giant monster and it's all going to repeat itself. And he's like, all right, I can fix this. And he's just sitting there being mad next to his pregnant bug wife and her sister. And she's like, and the sister's like, what's wrong? And he's like, I have to go. And he goes and he picks up his brain dead, nanomachine infested ex girlfriend, childhood friend who had to become stronger and definitely didn't succeed. And
she became more durable, though.
I guess. I mean, it didn't matter in the end.
I mean, you're right, but like, she's more durable than she was before. Like, I'm sure.
Probably.
I'm sure bullets would bounce off of her.
Probably.
You can use her as a shield.
Probably. but anyway. And then he's like, I have to go.
And hey, do you think Godzilla's scary? Yeah. So is thunder and lightning, I guess, and tornadoes. Do you hate them?
No.
Oh, what is hate?
We don't have hate.
All right, time to leave.
Nope, I gotta go.
I am the only one who contains hate.
And so he gets in the robot with his brain-dead, nanomachine-infested ex-girlfriend, childhood friend, must become stronger while in a mech suit, frickin' moron, and screams at Godzilla about how he hates him so much, and then gets blown the fuck. He literally abandoned his pregnant bug wife. Girlfriend, probably weren't actually married, but whatever. To go kill himself with his ex via giant lizard.
Look, we all knew this was gonna end with Godzilla blowing him.
It was explosive. Just fucking. I was literally, like, practically screaming. When I realized what he was doing, I was just like, I hate him. He could have just settled down with his bug girlfriend.
He felt rage.
I feel hatred, therefore I must die.
Look, if you hate things, Ghidorah is just gonna come back.
Oh my god.
Look. He had a mini Ghidorah on his shoulder the whole time, whispering in his ear, be mad! Hatred! Waffles!
Oh, forgot about how Mothra showed up.
Yes, the silhouette JPEG of Mothra.
The fucking garbage ass, like, just as bad as the Ghidorah silhouette. Jesus.
Just shows up in a dream sequence and goes, yep. Yeah. I'm here. I blew up a biplane or whatever the fuck it was. I blew up the World War II plane.
Yep.
The Millennium Falcon.
It kinda had a Millennium Falcon window going on.
Bye now.
See ya.
Was that a giant moth?
I believe the actual voiceover said butterfly.
I think it said moth.
Well, I mean, I know the subtitle said moth. We were busy laughing at the fact that Mothra did a thing. Because it was lame.
Mothra blew up a World War II plane.
A dream sequence World War II plane. What an achievement!
Mothra, truly the most powerful hang on a sec. I need to know the exact classification Mothra has. Mightiest monster in all creation. That's Mothra. I had to know.
But yeah, no, all of creation, mostly imagination. Anything else happened in this movie? Because I feel like nothing else happened in this movie.
The kids grew up and they went to the bug incarnation of Burning Man.
Yeah.
Which is to celebrate this man literally sacrificing himself and abandoning his bug girlfriend who was pregnant.
It was symbolic because now they're abandoning their fears, like having nightmares or falling out of trees. Or being bit by bugs. I don't remember what the fourth kid had.
I don't know. I don't care. This movie sucked ass.
Alright, let's throw some numbers at it.
The only saving grace of this movie is that he slept with the bug girl.
And then exploded.
In that order, but significant distance from each other. Hang on. It's in here somewhere. I'm pretty sure I actually set it up because I was smart this time. Yep, I did. Good. Monster combat. Jesus fucking Christ, what monster combat?
I mean, he got picked... At the very least, it should be higher than the last one.
He's getting bit by him, but we can't see it. It's not actually touching it.
That's not the combat, though. That's just the dialogue.
No, but it's describing the combat.
Remember when he bitch-slapped the Ghidora?
Yeah, gently? It was fucking lame.
But it was still more than he did in the last movie. What'd the last movie get anyway, like a 5?
Yeah.
Can we retroactively take points from that? So we can give this one a lower score?
I think we gave it a 5 because you had to count him fighting the mech things.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's what... Okay, yeah, give this a 4.
Yeah.
Or a 3.
3. Jesus. The visual effects. Ghidorah looked like shit.
Kind of everything looked like shit.
Yeah.
It actually kind of felt like a downgrade from the last one.
It was a bad time. Like, it immediately opened with, like... Just, like, really bad, juddery animations. It got better, but, like, it's like, it felt like they were saving money halfway through.
Well, you know how much money they spent on the Zone of the Ender robots in the last movie that they had? That's where the budget for this one went, to the last movie.
Clearly, because we had to spend, like, a third of the movie talking about what we were watching.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking garbage. Should have just made it porn. I have it down.
I mean, it probably would have had a better plot.
Probably.
Anyway, so like a 4 or something? For visual effects?
Yeah, that seems reasonable. Plot.
There was one.
Was there?
No.
No.
No, it was us waiting for Ghidorah to show up, and then us waiting for Ghidorah to leave. And then us waiting to find out which bug sister he banged.
Well, I'll be honest, I was waiting with bated breath to see if he would even bang one of them, and the first one tried to make a pass at him, he's like, you don't have to do that. And then I was
the other one knew how to undress him.
And I was like, the first time she started, like, stripping, I was like, yes! I literally threw my arms in the air. And then he, like, pushed her away, and I was like, oh, darn. And I started to lose it a little bit. And then he started thinking about who took off his suit and realized it was the other girl. And then she started hugging him and wasn't wearing anything. I was like, yes! And then he woke up next to her and they're both not wearing anything. I was like, yes!
I wish people could have seen that.
They'll hear it. Anyway, I cheered when he had sex with the bug lady. That's about it. I'm giving it, like, a fucking 2.
Yeah, that's...
This plot sucked.
Yeah, it really did. Yeah. Wow, this one's really tanking.
Oh, dude, this movie sucked ass. Acting.
You are lose. Together we win.
Oh, my god.
Except that probably goes to the dub.
Yeah, well, that was the subtitles. You are lose.
I think she said that.
Oh, I don't remember. Either way, it was hilarious, but yes, that would end up going in the dub. I don't know, like, the voice acting itself seemed on...
It was fine. Sojiro was still fine, even though it was just probably the same lines.
Actually, to be perfectly honest, it felt like most of the good voice actors died.
Well, that's because they couldn't pay them anymore.
Clearly. Because even Haruo was, like... He only had, like, a couple good scenes.
That's because all the scenes were... We can't see it. Or we can see it, but the instruments can't see it. But we can see it. It's right there. It's biting. It's not on the instruments, though.
I don't know.
Four. They made that scene believable. The whole talking in circles scene.
Clearly. Alright, the dub... I mean, the non-talking coming out of the bug ladies was like... I don't know,
I thought the bug ladies were probably the best part of the whole dub.
Well, yeah, they were great.
You are lose. We are win.
together we are win.
All your base belong to us.
The newer going there. I don't know.
Give it a point for the bug girls.
Special mention. I mean,
is it the bug sex? I feel like it's the bug sex.
It's either the bug sex or it's the suicide by Godzilla. Because... But the problem is that the suicide by Godzilla, to me, ruined the movie.
If they had been playing the Godzilla love theme as it happened, then it would have been perfect. But I'm thinking the bug sex.
Yeah, no, it has to.
Because you actively cheered for that.
Oh yes.
And while we were in the movie theater, I had to kind of put my head down so people wouldn't see who I was with the man cheering for bug sex.
Well, because it was. What was even better was, like, the first attempt at it. I was like, yes! And then he was like, no, I'm good. And I was like, oh, all right.
And then he got blueballed.
Damn. All right. And then he's like, wait, who took me out of my uniform? And I was like, why are we lingering on this? And then it was the other girl. And then she was wearing it. And I was like, yes! It was a roller coaster.
Two, three.
Hang on. Successful freaky bug sex. Because the last one was just freaky bug sex. But I have to differentiate it.
The act of bug sex.
Clearly.
Okay, so the other one gets potential bug sex. This one gets the act of bug sex.
Yes. Honestly, it considering potential was 3 points, this has to go higher.
Okay, so four.
Yeah, I don't want to give it too many points.
I just want to see this break 20, but I don't think it's going to do that.
It is.
Is it?
Five.
I feel like it shouldn't. I feel like it's not going to be breaking 20.
13, 14, ooh.
Is it a 19?
18.
Ah, we haven't been this bad since Showa.
Yeah, this was a Showa level of, like, straight-up garbage. It was almost as bad as Raids Again. Except Raids Again... It was almost as nebulous, but not quite. And it was just as unsatisfying an end.
Yeah, I mean, if only we had just frozen Godzilla in this movie, too.
Damn. Yeah, should have just buried him instead of suicide bombing
him. I mean, they buried the clothes, they buried the guns.
Yeah, no, just...
Why didn't we bury the Godzilla?
Well, but they tried to bury the Godzilla. That's what they did with the first one.
Yeah, and it worked.
Yeah,
but... We just gotta get bigger rocks.
I mean, they tried it with metal, and it didn't work. I mean, it did, but it didn't.
I mean, when they found him, they can go burning on command.
Holy shit.
Godzilla's smart enough to do that.
just vibrate his atoms.
Well, yeah, because he has a whole electromagnetic shield, whatever. Like, his...
Why can he do that, though? Like, I understand the shield, but I don't feel like that's, like...
But, no...
That should be a passive ability.
But the beam is actually the shield and the beam are one and the same. Because I don't know if you noticed how his...
Well, I mean, yeah, I just assumed it was...
He concentrates that energy, and then it fires off in a beam. It's actually really, really cool. There's a lot of really cool mechanical aspects. It feels like this entire fucking trilogy was based off of some really awesome ideas. Yo, and then they had to write a plot around it, and they weren't good at that.
Yeah, it feels like they went, hey, what can we do to make this spicy? Yeah, I know bug sex. And then he just sat back down, and everybody just said, well, he said bug sex, we gotta use it.
It's like, are we talking like real bug people? Well, no, we gotta make them humanoid. Like we gotta let the people not feel super weird if they start, you know, like getting off to it. So
are they gonna have compound eyes? No. I feel like they should have compound eyes.
No. Slap the extra eyes on the Ghidora.
Okay, fine. We'll put them there.
Just comment about how they're bug people. Just make sure that they know, and then it'll be like kind of titillating for the people who are into that stuff. But the people who are like, I don't know, like, but it looks really human, so maybe it's fine.
Good times.
Yep.
I want to be in that board meeting. Because I assume the guy who said bug sex immediately walked out. Like, he didn't even...
Metaphorically dropped the mic and left.
Slammed his hand down on his desk, said his piece, and then just left.
He might have left because he was in the process of getting a boner. But regardless... Oh, God. This fucking episode, dude.
Yeah, it's great.
And what sucks is that it would have been even more magical if they had caught the actual energy that I had when I first saw it as everything pieced together and the actual ending of the movie became this man abandoning his pregnant bug girlfriend to kill himself. Like, that hitting me all at once, I was yelling. I had my hands running through my hair, I was holding my head, and I was yelling. God, this movie sucked ass. Thank God he banged the bug lady.
It's all saving grace.
It's the one thing I wanted, and it's what I got. So, yeah.
Alright, so, on terms of power levels... where does this Godzilla stack up?
Fuck. At this point, like, the only thing I think he can't kill is... Gordonzilla.
I mean, Gordonzilla could throw him.
Well, no, I said the only thing he can't
throw. Yeah, I know what you're saying. Gordonzilla can throw Godzilla Earth. Godzilla Earth only weighs the same amount as Kaiser Ghidorah.
It's fucking stupid.
So you think he even beats Shin? Because at this point, he's competing for silver.
He's got a fucking electromagnetic energy shield. Like, if anything was built to withstand fucking energy beams, it's that goddamn shield.
Okay, so he is second.
Yeah.
Only because Gordonzilla can throw him to space.
Yeah. Well, and it's he's got the Gordon energy. Like, he's got the mustache and the katana. Like, what are you gonna do?
Cool. Now the list is looking really weird because it goes Gordonzilla, Earth, and then Shin. Amazing. I'm glad we didn't have to debate this one. Just get it over.
He's fucking three times taller than any of these guys.
That's true.
But he weighs the equivalent of Power Hour for his size.
No, I think Power Hour might be lighter. Relatively speaking.
Yeah, I guess.
No, you're probably right, actually, because each time you double the size of something, doesn't, like, the weight gain go up by, like, 8? Like, 8
eight times?
Four times. It's four times. Right. Well, it's... Wait. It's cubed per... Because as you gain in two dimensions, you... But you gain in a third because you're getting even bigger. So I think it is...
No, yeah, I think you're right. Well, I think it's four times.
Yeah, because it's the step from two dimensions to three dimensions, which is times four.
Yeah, so...
I think.
Theoretically speaking, if he was only 200 meters, he would be...
Oh, wait, no. Now I know what it is. Because it's, you're referring to a single dimension, but you have to go up by two. That's why it's times four. Because it goes from two... You go two, two squared is four, two cubed is... 8 divided by 2 is 4. There's the math! I did it! Fuck y'all. It's approximately 4 times. I mean, it's not exact, but whatever.
So he should probably weigh a lot more than what he actually does.
Yeah, but he's made out of...
He's made of plants.
Plant stuff. Even though that makes no sense. He's supposed to be the same fucking Godzilla.
He's made of Biollantes.
It's terrible. Okay. Biollante was a better movie. Anyway, Biollante was a better movie.
Are we retroactively going to give that more points?
No. No. It already nearly doubles this movie's score.
Wow. Amazing.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll see you next week for, what are we doing, Legendary?
We have to recap.
Ah, right, we do. We do gotta recap this.
Yeah, we do.
More freaky bug sex coming up next week. See you guys then.